Grand rising, everyone! As I let folk tune in and find me, I do apologize for coming in a little later. I kind of don't, to be honest. I want to go back into giving folk a minute, 30 seconds to find me. Because I'm finding when I open that 5-minute window at the beginning, I am losing people. I am learning that we are in a culture, a society, that if you do not grasp people's attention within the first few seconds, you lose them. So I love you guys who have been faithful, who are faithful, and continuously tune in, but I'm gonna have to kinda help us cultivate a mindset of being on time. And I know situations happen, so that's why I always have that little verbiage before I actually start the inspirational messages and meditations to allow you time to both find me and to get centered. And even if you notice, before I start each practice, I still get help us get into center. So everything is intentional, whether it looks like it or not on my end. So with that being stated, let me go into my welcome statement. For those of you first timers, first time viewing me, first time coming on here, I would like to thank you and welcome you. My name is Joseph Long, and I thank you for choosing this platform this morning. And all my returning viewers, hello friends, and thank you for your support. So I see Miss Pamela on here, grand rising to you. Yes, thank God it's Friday. Thank God for any day, actually, to wake up every morning, to breathe on my own accord, get myself out of bed. I didn't need any help. Miss Pat, I see you on hubby's cell phone. Grand rising to you. And then on Instagram, I see my sister, Miss Deborah. Grand rising to you, my friend. So this morning, we will do a power chakra guided meditation for activating our solar plexus chakra. This is also the third chakra in your body that governs your self-esteem, willpower, and ability for achievement. I see you, Miss Tony, all the way from England. Grand rising to you. It's been a while since I've seen you on live with me. So when I see you live, I feel extra blessed. So thank you. And I hope all is well with you. With that being stated, let's become centered. Begin by sitting in a normal meditation posture. Preferably cross-legged on the floor. Hence is why this morning I chose to be on my meditation mat on the floor. And if that's difficult, sit on a chair with your back and your shoulders straight. Alternatively, you can lie down on the floor, but you run the risk of dozing off. Take a few deep breaths and calm your body and mind. gently close your eyes. Take a long and deep breath. And as you exhale, move attention to the lower part of your chest, below the sternum, and imagine a bright yellow chakra. The sun-like yellow glow of the chakra spreads from your solar plexus to feel your chest first, and then the rest of your body. Imagine standing in an endless field of sunflowers or any yellow-colored flower swaying gently in the breeze. The sky is cloudless, blue, and the sun bathes you in the field of flowers with its warm, nourishing rays. Now, look up at the infinite expanse of sky. And lock your eyes on the sun. The rays don't hurt your eyes. You find it soothing and pleasant to look at the sun. You find yourself rising and being pulled by the sun toward itself. The yellow fields are now far below, and you are flying faster and faster. Even the earth has become a ball of blue in the distance. You get closer to the sun and register its true size for the first time. For all its heat and light, it looks warmly inviting and eager to embrace you. You head straight for its center. You become one with the sun's core and can see all the planets revolving around you. Now, see your third chakra spinning and gaining strength. As it spins faster, a yellow light washes over you and pervades every cell, every pore in your body. Breathe deeply. And feel the energy funneling down your spine to the third chakra. rest in this awareness. Gently start to float and fly again, this time toward the earth. You ride on the sun's rays back to the field of yellow flowers. Look back at the sun and feel one with it. Now, continue to fly back to your body. See your body where you left it, lying on the floor, sitting on a chair, or still in bed. Enter back in your body. When you're ready, open your eyes. Namaste. How do you all feel? I hope a little more energized, a little more empowered, and ready to take on whatever this day brings you. I see a comment from Miss Tony. My 11-month granddaughter enjoying your meditation with me. Oh, that's so cute. What's her name? And if she's still watching, I know she's kind of young, but hello, granddaughter. It's good to get them started young. I think that is a great start for them. To be in tune with their authentic self, with their higher self when they are young. Because they are noticing some schools are implementing meditation within their curriculum. I think that's a beautiful thing. Super happy. Thank you, Miss Deborah, for sharing that. Tamina. Hey, Tamina. All right. Okay, now for today's inspirational message, which comes from the daily publication of the Daily Word. And today's message is titled, I Have the Power to Shape My Life. You are blessed with spiritual powers and you use to create, to you. Let me back up. Mind going faster than my mouth. You are blessed with spiritual powers that you use to create your world. You, as you choose your thoughts, feelings, words, and actions, you are using your powers creatively and with intention. For instance, you express the power of love to contribute to a world of harmony and peace. You connect with your restorative power of life to send healing energy throughout your body. You use your power of understanding to deepen your awareness of your spiritual nature. When faced with a decision to make, you discern the options available to you through your power of wisdom and use your power of will to choose the best one. Your power of faith helps you believe those you hold in prayer are abundantly blessed. You are a divine being blessed with spiritual gifts that make you powerful beyond measure. Thank you, Miss Pamela, for touching and agreeing. Beautiful. Miss Pat, thank you. I feel relaxed and ready for whatever comes my way. Yes. Miss Tony laughing and pointing at you saying, Jojo. That's beautiful. I love the little people. So at that, let's pause here. I want you to ingest today's message. Everything I just said within the last 5 minutes. I want to ask you, and you could type it in the comment section if you choose to. What does the message from the Daily Word mean to you? What resonated with you after I read today's inspirational message? I tell you what resonated with me, and you can touch and agree, or you could have seen something totally different. I'm curious if something different came up for you, or if you can add on to what I'm about to say. What resonated with me this morning is that we are all powerful. Every one of us. I don't care where you came from, your ethnic group, your gender, your sexual orientation, whether you think you are pretty, ugly, whether you are tall, short, or you think you are fat or skinny, all of us were created and designed for a purpose. All of us were created with spiritual powers. The thing is, do you believe it? Rather, you are doing your daily practices to fine-tune, cleanse, or sharpen those powers. Whether or not you use those powers to obtain your dreams, to inspire and uplift others. To send love, healing, and power throughout our planet. Sending powerful vibrations out to the world for the betterment of this planet. Think about that. Ultimately, this message tells me we all have the power of choice. We all have free will. We have the power to shape our world the way we wish it to be or would like it to be. If we want more loving relationships, if we want financial abundance, if we want healthier bodies, it all starts from your thoughts, what you believe, your faith. So my brothers and sisters, as we soon go our separate ways on this fabulous Friday, may I encourage you to know that you are powerful and that with that power, you can shape your life. And so it is. Thank you, Miss Tony, touching and agreeing you believe. So if you find If you found today's meditation beneficial, or if today's message resonated with you, click on the like button, comment, and if you care to, share. We will not have a guided meditation tonight. Instead, do not be caught surprised if you see a post later on tonight. It will be, if I do, most likely I will. It will be a short, brief post. Now, as a friendly reminder, You may now subscribe to my YouTube channel. Tomorrow is the big day. May 1st, 2021 will be 1 year that I have been guiding live meditation sessions on my social media platforms. In celebration of this achievement, I have decided to expand my platform to YouTube. And I need your help. I have started loading my content into my YouTube channel, but I need a minimum of 1,000 subscribers to start going live stream on YouTube. So please click on my YouTube link and subscribe to my channel so that I may meet that goal. Also, tomorrow at 7 a.m., you will have access to the recording of my 1 year anniversary celebration recording exclusively on my YouTube channel. So let me forewarn my early birds. You may see me on Facebook Live early as 6 a.m. recording for this celebration. All righty. Any questions on that? Why wait for questions? Let me read your comments. I believe there is purpose to my being. Meditation helps me stay focused and pursue my purpose. I appreciate you sharing that, Miss Pamela. Wow, very powerful. I believe it and I receive it. Thank you. You're welcome, Miss Pat. We're ready for tomorrow. Thank you, Miss Kat. Grand rising to you, Miss Kat. I didn't know you was on here. Nearly my birthday. Yeah, Miss Tony. And what is your birthday? Share that with us, Miss Erin. Miss Pat, yes, for May 1st, 2021. Thank you, guys. All right. So, I want to thank you all for joining me in today's experience. I love you. And I appreciate you. Continue to go through this day energetic, energized, knowing that you are powerful. Peace and blessings. May 10th. And my granddaughter is May 17th. All right. Making a mental note of that. Miss Sheeta, I see you. I'm about to bring this to a close, but please, by all means, check out the video once we finish this session. Thank you, Miss Pamela. May you have a fabulous Friday as well.